Hello and welcome to NewsClick. We're going to discuss the election bonds issue which had come up in the front of the Supreme Court today, which we are expecting a verdict tomorrow. Very surprising claim made by the Attorney General, who said, Mr. Venugopal, who said that why do people have to know who's given the money? While he himself argues that there is no anonymity, because the argument of the election bonds has been the anonymity of the donations, because the Income Tax Department and the bank, Reserve Bank in this case, or State Bank in this case, anyway knows where the money is going or who has taken, bought the election bonds. So two conflicting situations. One, anonymity for the voter, but no anonymity for the party buying the election bonds and therefore to the government.
You are indeed, it's very, very unusual. And Arun Jaitley had used, I think, a slightly more sophisticated way of putting the same thing. That this is a way of ensuring that more the illegal money doesn't go in, that more of the donations go in through quote-unquote banking channels. But Mr. Venugopal, the Attorney General of India, what he told the Supreme Court was, in my opinion and the opinion of many others, rather unusual. And let me just quote what he said. He says voters have the right to know what. And then he said if political parties get money, it should not matter. The voters need not know where this money has come from so long as it is legal. Now wait, that was not all. And I quote him according to the law portals that have come out. He said every illegal move to woo voters is adopted. That is the way of life. Political leaders traveling in helicopters, huge money spent. Where does this money come from? It is black money. This is the Attorney General acknowledging that all this money or much of this money is black money. Then he goes on to say that why don't you allow this scheme to run as a quote-unquote experiment and let the new government, when it comes to power, take a call on whether to continue or not. Now, I personally believe that right from day one, in fact, if you recall, it was announced by Mr. Arun Jaitley, the finance minister, in the budget, which was in February 2017. But it was finally introduced in January 2018.
As a part of the money bill.
Yes. But these are financial instruments. I mean, everybody says, what are these bonds? Why are they called bonds? You know, bond, in financial markets, a bond is like a debt instrument. But this is akin to what is called a promissory note. That you promised to pay the bearer of this note X amount of money. Now, it meant that anybody, an individual or an entity, any kind of entity, including a corporate entity, could buy on designated dates, designated amounts of money from the State Bank of India. As the Chief Justice of India, Mr. Ranjan Gogoi, he pointed out, he said that if indeed those who purchase these bonds, they have to go through KYC. I mean, know your customer norms. That means, in other words, the State Bank of India knows who has purchased the bond.
What?
Right? Then he says, this is not me, but the Chief Justice saying, the entire exercise of fighting black money becomes futile.
I will just take a step back on all of that. The argument that Jaitley has been giving, that vindictive action can be taken by new government, or the party which comes into power. Therefore, this anonymity of the person taking the or giving the money to the political party is good because it protects him.
Now, there's a counter argument to this.
No. But this is Jaitley's argument of this is why it is being introduced. Apart from now, the new one that is giving, that instead of black money in elections, this is white money. And I'm not getting into the issues, has black money reduced or not. But let us take the argument on its face value.
Okay.
That effectively, somebody giving money to a political party can be victimized by the ruling party. The ruling party has got the maximum amount of money in this. Now it transpires, the ruling party in any case would know who has purchased the bonds.
One minute. Let's go step by step. The identity of the purchaser of these electoral bonds, that is known to the State Bank of India because of the know your customer norms. Now, the details of who has purchased these bonds are kept confidential, or they're supposed to be kept confidential by the bank and forward to the central repository at the end of the month. But everybody who buys the bond has to give it to a recognized political party. And eventually that will get reflected when that party submit its accounts to the Election Commission of India. Now, the interesting part of the story is what the lawyers pointed out. Rakesh Dwivedi, arguing for the Election Commission of India, said we do not oppose to bonds per se, but to the anonymity, because they want...
Still, we are coming to that point.
Okay.
But the point I'm making is, one of the argument is that while there is anonymity to the voter, which is what the Attorney General said, Venugopal has said, but there is no anonymity in front of the ruling regime.
Okay.
Because just hold on.
Okay.
Because the Income Tax Department, Mr. Venugopal is saying this, not me, not you. Mr. Venugopal says Income Tax Department in any case knows it.
1 minute. So that is two or three assumptions we are making. That when the State Bank of India provides this information to the central repository, the Ministry of Finance, including the Income Tax Department, can get to know who has bought how much bonds. This is the assumption. Now, Prashant Bhushan, who was the advocate representing the Association for Democratic Reforms, one of the civil society organizations besides the Communist Party of India, Marxists, who are petitioners in this case, he said that according to him, the 220 crore bonds that have been purchased so far, 210 have gone to the Bharatiya Janata Party. Now, the question that we have
this was the first set of bonds which are released. This is in 2018.
There have been various series.
Yes, but I'm saying we should not think 250 crores is all that we are talking about.
No, it could be much, much more
it's
than
much
that.
It's much higher. It's about something like 2,000 crores because the last tranche was much bigger.
You see, the point is we have no way of knowing, really, unless this information is disclosed. Now, all the media reports that have been pointed out seem to be dependent on leaks coming from the government. And the other interesting part of the story, and this is the whole thing about recognizing who's bought whom, an investigation done by the portal Quint found out that each of these bonds actually have a serial number. So that means each of these bonds are numbered. So you can match the serial number of the bond with the person who's purchased it. The short point is.
And the party depositing it. So all the correlations
the
are
short
there.
Point is, we will know what the Supreme Court will have to say on Friday, the 12th of April. But those who believe this is nothing, I mean, though Mr. Jaitley claims it's going to bring greater transparency to political funding, in fact, it can be argued that the reverse is the case, that this has really provided a new channel to individuals and corporates to donate money to parties.
You know, Paranjoy, I was in fact talking about today only what Venugopal has argued. Because if we go to the election bonds, the issue is any entity anywhere in the world can give money through election bonds. It can set up a company in India. That company may have no business except giving money to a political party.
It could be a shell company. It could be a dummy company.
It would be a shell company if it had no other business. So all of this is permitted. And observers or analysts who have analyzed this have said this is the most permissive scheme we've ever seen in terms of election funding in any country in the world.
You know, it's truly amazing. And when the Attorney General of India raises a question, whether the voters have the right to know how their political parties are getting the money.
The big news is that today, that the voters don't have a right to know, but the government,
will get to know.
So, and therefore, the Jaitley argument that actually this is to keep those identities secret from the powers that be, so he's not penalized, that argument has been today contradicted by the attorney.
Now, you can turn that entire logic of the electoral bonds on its head and say that if the government of the day knows who is purchasing the bond and therefore will also know to whom eventually to where it has gone, it will actually dissuade donors from giving any money to the political opponents of the government because they'll feel they're going to be victimized. And if indeed these figures that have been put out, 90% of the money or more than 90%, 95% of the money has gone to the BJP, then that would just, reinforce this contention.
Thank you very much for Paranjoy for being with us. Keep watching NewsClick and do visit our website.